Hi, Kate. Thanks for having me on the blog today. I'm super excited to answer some of your questions about you're invited to a moth ball.
Where did you get the story seed for you're invited to a moth ball?
Well, back in 2014, I went to a talk at my local Audubon sanctuary. And at that talk, there was a naturalist whose name is David Small from Massachusetts, talking about the moths that he had seen over the years in his backyard. Now, I live about an hour from where Dave lives, and I had seen maybe a dozen or two different species of moths at my house, all small brown moths. And Dave, in this lecture, showed us hundreds of species of moths that he had seen in his yard, not an hour from my house. And they weren't small and drab at all. They were these large, in some cases, very colorful, very exciting, very unusual, striking moths. And I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe that those kinds of moths lived near me. And when I talked to Dave about why I hadn't seen them, he made it very clear. You have to stay up late, much later than I was staying up to watch moths. Most moths are more active between the hours of midnight and 2 a.m. And if you're like me, you're sleeping at that time of day or that time of night. So by staying up later and by also using a couple tricks to convince moths or lure moths, if you will, into your observation space, you can see a lot more moths. And that's what this book is about. So the idea grew out of that lecture and then the time I spent with Dave Small learning about moths and moth watching. Everything I learned from him and a whole lot more ended up in this book.
How often do you have moth balls?
So in the years since, I've attended moth balls at Dave's house and learned a lot from him. I now have my own lights and I know how to make bait. And that those are the two ways that you will learn in the book that we can entice moths into our green spaces. So I have my own lights. I know how to make bait. So I, in the summer months, usually in July and August, I try and have my lights on and or put bait out a couple times a week. If it's going to be a very warm, clear evening during those months, chances are I'm going to be trying to stay up late to see which moths come to visit my lights and bait.
What are some interesting things that you've learned from Dave?
So I've learned from Dave and a bunch of other mentors that I've had, actually, a lot of things about moths. Some of them I write about in the book. I tell you about one of my mentors named Taya, who taught me some interesting things about female moths and egg laying, and I hope you'll read about that. One of the other things that I've learned that was super interesting is that the moth life cycle, which you probably know is a four-part life cycle. Moths are eggs, and then out of that egg hatches a caterpillar or a larva. When the larva is ready to transform, there's a pupal stage, which we often call a cocoon for moths. And out of that cocoon will eventually emerge an adult moth. Those life stages for each individual species of moth is timed in a very particular way to the season. It often has to do with what their host plant species is and when that is around. But what I've learned is there are patterns to moth life cycles. And the more you observe moths, the more you learn those patterns. So for example, it is April here in Massachusetts where I live. Not many adult moths are out and about yet, but there is one moth called the halfwing that is an early moth. It is an adult moth. That's the stage of its life cycle it's at in early spring. And so I see that moth now. I am pretty sure that that's not a moth that I will see at the end of the season in the fall, for example. So there are patterns to moth life cycles, and the more you watch them across the moth watching season, the more you get to a feel for those and become familiar with them. And that's something I learned from my moth mentors.
Tell us about your revision process.
So my revision process is probably very similar to a lot of the writers who are visiting your blog. I knew from the very beginning I wanted to tell the story of a single moth watching event, and I wanted this book to feel like a party that you've been invited to. So I knew the title very early, You're Invited to a Moth Ball, would serve as an invitation. And I wanted readers to arrive at this event during daylight hours and be involved in the setup for a moth watching event. And then I wanted the sun to go down and the moths to come and the watchers to stay up and watch the moths that arrive and learn something about them. The trick for me was to write that all down in a way where you followed that party trajectory, but you also got the information about moth life cycles and moth personalities and preferences at the time that you needed it in the story. So I wrote that all out, and then I did what many, many writers do, which is I shared that with trusted writer friends who read the story as I had written it and could tell me the places where the story was working well and the places where they had all the information they needed at the moment they needed it, and the places, this was more important to me, the places where things got confusing, the places where they didn't know what they needed to know when they needed to know it. And so I would take those comments, come back to my desk, and rewrite the story based on those comments, try and fill in the blanks and fix the places where things were confusing. And then I repeated this process many times. I gave my new draft to my readers or to my editor, and they read it, found the places that worked, found the places that didn't work, and let me know about both, gave me back the manuscript, and then I came back to my desk and once again tried to fix those places where things got difficult for my readers. That was my revision process. That is my revision process for every book I make, actually. And I'm pretty sure it's probably a revision process that some of you use as well. So, Kate, again, thank you for having me. It was a real pleasure to answer some of your questions. I'd be happy to answer more if anyone has them. Just put them in the comments on the blog post, and I'll answer if I'm able. If you do read You're Invited to a Moth Ball, I hope you have a great time and start watching moths in your own backyard. Take care. Bye.